There is a version of Windows that you probably have never heard of before, but have used without realizing it. It's called Windows PE. Now, when I say a version of Windows, you might be thinking something like Windows 10 Pro or Home, but I don't mean that kind of version. On the contrary, Windows PE is not made for just general daily computer use at all, but it is still very useful. For example, for creating bootable USB rescue drives that you can use to save your computer if it's broken and won't boot or something like that. So in this video, I'm gonna explain what is Windows PE all about, and also how you can create your very own Windows PE bootable disk if you want from your own computer, so stick around. But before we continue, I want to thank today's sponsor, Morning Brew, the free high-quality daily newsletter that will keep you up to date on the latest in tech, business, and finance in just 5 minutes from Monday to Sunday. It's a much better way to start the day than what I used to do, which I don't know about you, was mostly just spending a bunch of time reading useless crap on social media. Unlike traditional media though, Morning Brew only curates the most relevant and informative stories. For example, just the other day, I was reading it and learned that Las Vegas is apparently getting the world's first cloud 5G network, which is the latest marketing buzz, which means that companies are going to start building backbones of 5G networks on Amazon's web services in the cloud, not just using their own data centers. So this could potentially allow the faster rollout of additional 5G networks around the nation. Good to know. To sign up for Morning Brew, which again is completely free, just go to the link in the description and then enter the email address you want to get the daily newsletter delivered to, and that's it. And so, with all that being said, let's continue. All right, so what exactly is Windows PE anyway? Well, it stands for pre-installation environment, and it's basically a very stripped down, lightweight version of Windows. It's mostly used for things like deployment of Windows, meaning the installation of Windows maybe on hundreds of computers for an organization or just one computer, your installation. Or it can be used for troubleshooting and running outside of the normal Windows installation if it won't run. Because unlike a full version of Windows, Windows PE is designed to be so lightweight that it can be booted from a portable device, such as a USB drive, and it can be as small as just 300 megabytes to run. And these Windows PE installations are created using the so-called Windows Assessment and Deployment Kit, or ADK, which is a tool that is free to download from Microsoft off their website. And like I said before, you probably have actually used a version of Windows PE before without realizing it. For example, the installation of Windows, when you insert the Windows installation disk or USB disk, that actually boots up using Windows PE and then installs it from there to the full version. Or the Windows recovery environment. If Windows fails to boot up, then it brings up a bunch of tools and stuff, and that's all running in Windows PE, which kind of makes sense. It's good to have a super alternative, lightweight operating system that can boot up if the main one isn't working, and that can potentially be used to fix the main one. If you saw one of my previous videos talking about different USB boot drive and rescue disks you can create, you might have heard me talk about Hyrin Boot CD, which is a rescue disk that has a bunch of tools on it, and that actually is built using Windows PE. It looks like Windows 10, and they added stuff in like the shell to make it actually look like that and all those other tools. But even though it looks like a regular version of Windows with the whole full desktop interface and stuff, make no mistake, it's not a full version of Windows and it's very limited. It's really only good for some of the bare basics, like maybe web browsing. This is not something you could use for daily browsing and daily usage because it doesn't have, for example, all the dynamic link libraries and backend software that Windows has that a lot of software relies on. So you're not going to be playing any games or anything like this or running complicated software. You can't even install anything to it because it doesn't have all the stuff that all those other softwares rely on. The reason you can add tools and stuff to it is because a lot of those tools have portable versions where everything needed to run those programs is contained with it alongside it, but stuff that you have to actually download and install probably wouldn't work. But again, it's still very useful because it's able to run a lot of those useful tools outside of Windows. So why don't I go over how you can build your very own USB boot drive with Windows PE on it. Again, it's going to be kind of limited, so you might just be better off downloading a pre-made one with a bunch of tools added, but this will still be pretty interesting because it goes over a lot of stuff you probably didn't even know was in Windows, and maybe better understanding in the future could potentially mean that you can fix things better in the future. So the first thing you're going to have to do is go on Microsoft's website. Again, I'll put the links in the description and download the Windows ADK Assessment and Deployment Toolkit. After you download and run it, it may actually say that you already have Windows ADK installed, in which case you could uninstall it and reinstall this one to update it, or you could try the rest of this without updating. I don't know how well it'll work. Anyway, I realized that apparently I did have it installed already, so I just uninstalled that one and reinstalled this new one I just got. When you run the installer, installer, just select to install it to this computer and then take note of that install path, and then just go next until you get to the feature section. You can just do all the defaults, or if you want, you can check them all and install everything if you want. And then it'll just go and install. After that though, you'll also have to download the separate Windows PE add-on for the ADK. It's not actually included in that. You have to download a separate thing. I'll put that link, of course, too. So just run that installer now, select install for this computer again, and then go until it says select features, which there is only one available, the Windows PE thing. It's about 5.5 gigs, and then do the same thing, install it, and then it's gonna go into this directory, the program files 86, Windows kits 10, and then assessment and deployment toolkit. So now that's installed, to actually use it, you go into the start menu and do a search for deployment and imaging tools environment. It should come up, and then run that as an admin. So note that it opens to the same install directory as a CMD command prompt window, but this is not the same as just opening CMD and going to that directory. For some reason, you have to actually make sure that this environment program is running like is shown being in the window title. So after that window is open, the command we're gonna use is copy PE. So if you just type that in, it's gonna show some info about it and the syntax. And you can see that in the brackets, some of the parameters you're gonna need are the different CPU architectures. Most of you will just use AMD 64, which is just 64-bit processors. Even if it's Intel, it's still gonna be called AMD 64. And x86 is for 32-bit processors, which aren't really that common anymore. And you can check if you want to be sure, if you go to About PC and it says x64-based processor, that's AMD 64. The next parameter will be the working directory, which is basically the location it's gonna put the files temporarily, and that can be wherever. So all put together, the command I'm gonna use is copy PE and then AMD 64, and then the location I'm gonna put it is in the top level directory, C:\WinPE is all I'm gonna call it. One thing to understand is this working directory is not where it's actually installing this USB bootable thing too. So don't set this location to the USB flash drive. Think of it sort of like baking a cake, where you get all the ingredients together and kind of put everything in a pan first before you put it in the oven. That's basically what we're doing here. The working directory is basically the pan where you put all the ingredients in, and then once everything's added, then you can burn it to the actual USB, and that would be where you're putting it in the oven in our analogy. So we're just kind of preparing things in this working directory first. So don't set it to the USB drive, it won't work. After you run this command, it will simply say success, and then you can see that the folder is there where I set. Now at this point, the next step is just going to be running the program to actually take those files and burn it onto the USB drive in a special way so it'll actually work. But you could at this stage also add stuff into the Windows PE installation. However, if you do it using the official Windows methods that is on Microsoft's website, it's actually extremely complicated, and you have to basically install certain packages after mounting WIM files, I forget what they stand for, and you have to copy packages from one into the other. It's kind of a nightmare, and they're not actually any really useful packages anyway for most people. So you can read about that on Microsoft's website if you want to be able to do this, but for this example, we're just going to do the most basic version. So to actually put this onto the USB drive, make sure you have an empty USB drive that you don't care about any of the data on it, because this is going to be completely wiped and formatted. So make sure that's plugged in, and then we're going to go back into that same ADK window we were using before. The command we're going to be using is make WinPE media, and again, if we just type it in like that, it's going to show some info about it and the syntax, and you can see that it says it creates a bootable WinPE flash drive or ISO, and I'm paraphrasing there. You can either do the parameter UFD or ISO. UFD stands for USB flash drive, and in that case, the whole drive is going to be formatted just used for Windows PE. And for ISO though, it's going to make an ISO that you can later use to burn onto one or multiple USB disks or CDs. Then the two locations we put are first the working directory, then the destination, so the thumb drive or the ISO location. Note the order here, don't mix them up or you could risk like formatting the entire wrong hard drive or something like that. So first we can do the super basic version, which is just formatting a whole drive, and then we'll do the ISO, which is actually probably better, and I'll show you why after that. So for this, we can put in our own parameters as make WinPE slash UFD, and then location C:\WinPE, that's our working directory, and then my flash drive is in drive M. Double check again to make sure that the drive letter is correct. It will say it to confirm it, And then once you run it, it's just gonna copy the files over. And then you can see once it's done that the WinPE directory is only about 300 megabytes. So at this point you could just plug that USB in and it'll boot to WinPE, but let me show you next how to do the ISO version, why I think this is actually probably better. So this time the command will be make WinPE media slash ISO, and then the location of the working directory, again, C WinPE. And then where I'm gonna put the ISO, I'll just put it in there again, C WinPE, and call it winpe.iso. Take note that for the ISO location, you have to write out the whole thing, including the name you wanna call it. And you also have to choose a directory that already exists or else you'll get an error. It's not gonna create a new folder if the one you put doesn't exist yet, for example. But after you run it, you can see it's in there. It was pretty much instant for me, maybe because I have an SSD, but way faster than making the USB. Now at this point, you could just burn the ISO onto the USB drive with another program, and then it would basically be like the other one we made directly. But there's actually a better option I recently found out about called Ventoy. It's a software that everyone was telling me about in the comments of my USB boot drive video, and basically it allows you to create a multiple bootable USB drive. So instead of just having to make one USB drive per bootable disk, you can actually put as many as you want as it'll fit on one drive, and you can select that when you're booting up the computer, which is way awesome. I'll put the link of that in the description, but once you run Ventoy and use it to set up a USB drive, it'll create a bunch of partitions. Some of them you won't be able to see, but for the one that is visible, called Ventoy, literally all you do is copy and paste ISOs into that USB drive, and then those are the ones that will be selectable and bootable from the screen when you boot up the computer. Quick note, however, one reason you might choose not to use Ventoy though is because it might not play well with something called Secure Boot, which is basically a security feature in a lot of computers these days that only boots using certain signed softwares. Now with the Windows PE standalone disk or most other standalone disks, that's all signed, so you shouldn't have any problem really. But with Ventoy, you might have to either disable Secure Boot on your BIOS settings, which isn't too hard, but you might not know how to do it. Or alternatively, Ventoy does actually support Secure Boot, but you have to go through a couple extra steps. For example, enabling it and choosing to enable it when you set up the USB drive initially, and you're gonna have to go through several steps on the first time you run it on a particular computer. All those instructions will be on Ventoy's website, and I was able to follow them and get it working, but you might not want to have to deal with that. You might be scared of looking at some of the complicated stuff, but it's not too hard if you just follow it. So it'll still work, you just have to be aware of that. All right, so now in any case, no matter how you're gonna boot up, whether with Ventoy or just making a standalone disk, it should be good to go. You plug it in, you boot into it, and then what you'll see is a command prompt window. And that's basically it. So yes, it is more bare bones than maybe you were even expecting. However, that doesn't mean that just because it's command line that it's not useful. In fact, there are several tools that are normally built into Windows that you can now access from here and could potentially be used to fix your computer. For example, there's disk part for messing around with disk partitions and stuff. There's DISM, which can be used to validate the integrity of different system files and stuff like that. Same with SFC, that's also very similar, system file checker, same use. And even BCD edit for changing the boot records and stuff like that. There are plenty more though. If you do the command dir and then the filter star exe, this will show you all the different exes that you can run right from this command line. Now this is gonna show all the executables here, so some are just background, not actually tools, but it will show some utilities too. So you can see check disk in there, for example. I forgot to mention that one. So yeah, this is cool and all, though it is limited. There's not even really a desktop. However, you can actually technically access Windows Explorer if you run Notepad, yes, that's in here too. And then if you go to File, Open, well, there's your Explorer window right there. You can actually navigate through there, delete stuff, copy stuff, whatever. It just might not be what you're usually used to, but it might still work. All right, so that's pretty cool, but what if you wanted to create, again, your own Windows PE boot drive, but do want to add certain custom programs and stuff? Well, the easiest way to probably do that would be using a program called Win10XPE. This program basically lets you create a customized WinPE boot disk, and it allows you to choose from a whole bunch of different tools that have been pre-prepared for Windows PE. You just select which ones you want to add. When you do run it, you'll see it's called WinBuilder. That's because I believe the Win10XPE is the name of the project and it uses WinBuilder, but anyway, it's the same thing. Keep in mind though, to get this program actually working and to actually use it, you will have to disable your antivirus because there are a couple false positives negatives that might show up. Now, that being said, everything I've read about it indicates that it's completely safe and they are indeed false positives. I have not heard anyone saying that it actually is a secret virus. It's a pretty popular program and I ran it myself. So if it still sketches you out, maybe don't run it, but just know that you are gonna have to disable your antivirus to run. So anyway, first it's gonna have you download a specific ISO for a version of Windows, and it's gonna have links to where you can download that. After you do download and then select the ISO, you then go in and simply choose the programs you want to add and include or not. So you can see me going through a whole bunch of these in here, and there's all sorts of different categories like antivirus, utilities, networking and stuff. There's some media ones. For example, there's Media Player Classic and VLC Media Player in there that weren't selected by default, so I added those in. Also, it didn't have Firefox selected, only Google Chrome, so I figured why not add that in. I pretty much selected everything except for a couple that I knew would be kind of useless, because I did really intend to use this kind of as a potential future rescue disk for my own self. After you select all the programs, there are a ton more customizations. Like, you can choose the profile picture, the wallpaper, all sorts of themes and stuff. I'm not gonna get into that, just know that those options are there if you really wanna dig down into it. But once you have everything selected, you simply click the play button, and that's gonna go through and compile and create this boot disk and put it into an ISO that can then be used and burned onto the drive in a number of ways. So this could take a while. If you get any breaking error messages or something, it probably is your antivirus blocking it, but I'll just fast forward anyway. So anyway, once it's done, you'll see that the ISO is in the same folder as the program we just ran. So again, you can make this bootable in any number of ways, either using Ventoy or just using a regular ISO burner to put it on a CD or a USB. I'm just gonna use Ventoy again, and maybe I'll rename these to something a little bit more easier to recognize. So anyway, once you boot it up, it's gonna look a lot more familiar, like the regular Windows 10 that I'm used to. And you can see it does have all those tools and stuff that I selected. It's all either on the desktop or in the start menu and stuff like that. You got the full Windows Explorer, you can look through the different drives. Very, very useful, could come in handy. So obviously Windows PE is very useful, but you don't actually have to go through the whole hassle of creating your own Windows PE boot drive, whether using the official Microsoft tools or even using this Win10X PE software. Instead, you could just go online and search for Windows 10 PE rescue disks, and there are several projects people have made. And since they are pre-made, usually they just come as pre-packaged ISOs, so they're extremely easy to install. You can either burn it directly or, again, run off Ventoy, so no building or compiling or anything required. Like I mentioned, I'd probably get Pyrin Boot CD PE is probably the one I'm the most familiar with, so that's really the only one I'm gonna mention. I haven't used any of the other ones, but you might be able to find it. But in any case, now you know a little bit more about how Windows works, and you probably came out of this with a new rescue disk that you could use the next time disaster strikes on your computer. So thanks again to Morning Brew for sponsoring this video. Again, be sure to click the link in the description and sign up for Morning Brew's daily newsletter so you can stay up to date on the latest in tech, business, and finance. If you guys want to keep watching, the next video I'd recommend is that previous video I mentioned where I go over four different bootable USB drives that you should probably make before it's too late, and they could really come in handy. So you can just click that right there. And thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you in the next one.